Hi guys, my name is Mike, and so as everybody already knows, pipe organs are amazing, but they don't appear that frequently in computer music, at least not in the kind of DIY, hardware hacking, maker type of computer music that I'm interested in. And of course, that's because most people don't have access to a pipe organ. And maybe you could build one, but it turns out to be very complicated to build a pipe organ. Well, it just so happens, in the course of my research, that I built these miniature, kind of simplified computer-controlled pipe organs. And in the process of doing so, I developed some tools and techniques that will hopefully facilitate other people to build their own. And so today I kind of want to walk you through how you would go about building something like this. And so this pipe organ basically just has four components. So there's this air supply. Then these black boxes down here are called wind chests. And of course there are organ pipes. And then finally, you have some sort of computer that controls the whole thing. And I want to go through each one of these in a little bit of detail so you can see. And I'll start with the organ pipes because that's probably the most difficult thing to build. And so this is one of the organ pipes that I built. And so the blue part is 3D printed, and the black part is actually laser cut out of plywood and then painted black. And so if you wanted to make your own organ pipe like this, what you could do is visit this website that I made, and you just need to enter some information about the note you want to make, and you can select whether you want an open or closed pipe, and you enter some information about the material you're going to be using, and some more information about the timbre of the pipe you're interested in. And then down at the bottom here, you basically just get two files out. So the first one is a 3D printer file, which you can download. And the second one is a laser cutter file, and you can also download that. And so the 3D printer file, you just open that up and of course then print it on your 3D printer. And then you can remove the support material. And so then this is what the finished part looks like. Okay, and then the laser cutter file, of course you laser cut that out of plywood, as I said, and you end up with all these parts, and there's also a little part out of felt that you can either laser cut or just cut with scissors. And so you need to glue all of those up, and this is kind of the bottom resonator part of the pipe. And then there's additionally a tuning slide that goes on top of that that you can use to tune the pipe later. So you glue that all together. And then this is kind of what that looks like once it's been painted. And so both parts are there and you just epoxy those together. And then this is what the finished pipe looks like. And so I actually built a rank of 24 of these pipes. And so this is what a couple of them sound like. Okay, so now I'll tell you about the wind chests. So this is what one of those looks like once all the stuff is moved away from it. And there are all these holes on the top, and the organ pipes just kind of slot down into those holes. And then so this is what it looks like once you open it up. And so it's basically just an empty box. But here at the back of the box, there's kind of an air inlet. So air from the air supply will come in there and pressurize the inside of the box. And then over here, this is kind of the lid of the box and it's been turned over. And so then underneath each one of the organ pipes, there's one of these pipe valves. And this is what the pipe valve looks like. It's basically just a special electromechanical device that covers the bottom of the pipe with a felt pad. And then when you apply 12 volts to it, the pad moves away from the bottom of the pipe, which allows air to go into the pipe and sound. So to make a note sound, you basically just need to apply 12 volts to the corresponding pipe valve. And then so this is the air supply. Maybe it's kind of hard to see what I've circled there, but this is what it looks like on its own. And this is basically just a big soundproof box with a fan inside of it. And so the fan I use is this kind of crazy, like, counter-rotating server cooling fan, which is easily like 10 or 20 times more powerful than any regular CPU fan would be. And so this actually ended up working great. The only problem is that it's really, really loud. It's like a jet engine. And so that's why I encased it in this soundproof box. And this is kind of the cross section of that box. So you can see the fan in there, and it's just completely surrounded by soundproofing. And then also there's a little pressure sensor in there that I can use to control the speed of the fan and regulate the air pressure at the output of the fan.
And then there's this large hose coming out of the air supply. And so the air just flows out through here. And in my case, I have it flowing into this junction box. And from here, the air flows through this other hose up into the back of the wind chest and into the air inlet, which I showed you before.
And then this is the schematic of the air supply there. And the reason the air supply is so long is because there are sound baffles at either end, and the sound baffles allow air to flow through without giving a direct line of sight for sound to come through. And so this box ended up reducing the sound of the fan by about 20 decibels, which is quite nice. And it's not inaudible, but it's not that loud. Especially if the organ is actually playing music, you don't really hear the sound of the air supply. And then finally, of course, you need some sort of circuitry that is capable of actually supplying 12 volts to each of the pipe valves. And for that, I use this cute little octopus-shaped robot, which I previously built for a different project. But for the sake of these pipe organs, this is basically just a 12-volt solenoid controller that can be controlled via USB MIDI. So you plug this thing into your computer and you send MIDI note messages to it, and it will supply 12 volts to the corresponding pipe valve. And so yeah, then this is what the finished pipe organ sounds like. So yeah, that's it. I think that's all I have to say about that for now. If you like this video, remember to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye!